Next on Health Tech Today.
We're able to talk to anybody that's in a meeting and there's that instantaneous connection. It's brilliant.
Join us for this story about how the deaf community is finding a new avenue for communication. Deaf people face difficult challenges when trying to access information and services through hearing organizations. Often the wider hearing community doesn't consider the needs of the deaf. Established in 1884, the Victorian Deaf Society is the main provider of specialized communication services for deaf adults in Victoria, Australia. VicDeaf, more than most organizations, depends on visual communication. Joining us from Australia is named account manager Jeff Bogensberger from Generation E, one of our terrific Microsoft partners. Thanks, Jeff, for joining us here on Health Tech Today, and welcome to our show.
Hi, Bill. Thanks for having me.
You know, I'm such a huge advocate for communication and collaboration tools in healthcare. And when I heard about this story, I thought, here's a compelling use for video. So tell me about VicDeaf and this solution that you came up with.
This is a group of people that fight every day to be as productive as they can be. They were originally looking at other video conferencing type solutions like Skype and various SMS type offerings, but they just weren't sophisticated enough to meet the needs of a pretty dynamic organization. This is right around the same time where Microsoft was releasing Lync 2010, great product with regard to unified communication and its ability to integrate the concept of video conferencing and the ability to make every meeting a potential face-to-face meeting. It was a huge selling point to VicDeaf.
So tell me, what's the customer saying about this solution? Is it meeting their needs? What's the feedback you're hearing?
There's a whole group of people that are realizing a level of potential in the workplace and in their professional and personal lives that they just couldn't have done without Lync. It's great. I was in there yesterday, and every time I walk out, I got a smile on my face.
Jeff, one of the issues that always comes up whenever you introduce new technology is it easy to use? Is it intuitive? Do I need a lot of training? What's been your experience with that question?
Because it's based on a Microsoft platform and the tools that are available are very similar to the Microsoft Outlook, Excel, Word, everything that people are used to using every day. We did a 3-hour training session and everybody grabbed a hold of it. Like any new technology, if you embrace it and you use it and you learn how to take advantage of it, it becomes a great experience, and that's what's happened at VicDeaf.
What seems to be the biggest value that this solution adds to the organization and the work they do?
The collaboration tools, the increased morale, the extending their reach to a community that otherwise has challenges. The conversations are moving. How do we now extend this to our community further? How do we utilize this great technology to really benefit the people that we're servicing, the hearing impaired community?
VicDeaf is a great example of a forward-thinking organization that's willing to try new ways of communicating. Do you see other situations that these enhanced communication and collaboration tools would be of particular value?
This is a product that can help anyone that has challenges that may be a bit unique to them as far as communication goes. Perhaps an organization that deals with physically handicapped people. All of a sudden, the home workplace becomes very real possibility at a very cost-effective way. So all of a sudden, you have someone that may have difficulty getting into an office is all of a sudden able to realize their full potential because it doesn't matter anymore.
Well, Jeff, thanks so much for taking time today to tell us a little bit about Generation E and your customer, the Victorian Deaf Society. We very much appreciate you joining us on Health Tech Today.
Thanks a lot, Bill.
Learn more about Microsoft Lync, the next generation of communication server.
On behalf of our staff and sponsors here at Health Tech Today, I want to thank you for joining us. I enjoy hearing your feedback, so please log on to my health blog and send me your questions and comments. Join us regularly for more and the latest in healthcare IT.
For more thoughts, comments, news, and reflections on healthcare IT, join Dr. Bill Krause on Health Blog.